This video is slightly different from my usual one. This is for showing the internal files for Affinity Photo. If you're on a Mac, this is not for the PC. So if you're on PC, my apologies, nothing to do with PC. I don't know, I haven't got a copy of Affinity Photo on my PC. So where are these files, these Affinity Photo as well as Affinity Designer? Now they should normally be in application support in your library. So go to your library, simply go to Go up here to the Finder. That's the key thing, Finder, and go to Go, and then you can see library there. If you can't see it, hold down the Alt or Option key and it should display the library then. If not, go to Folder and just simply go to the folder, the tilde and then slash library. So once you've got that, you're into your library and you'll notice there's a lot of files. There's accounts, whatever it is, application support, and so on. Now, normally, if you go to application support, you will find designer and photo in there. But if you go in there and find you can't find it, because I've got Affinity Publisher, that's in there, but it's not for me, and it may be the same for you, and that's why I'm doing this. Joseph pointed this out to me, contacted me and said, this is the location, containers, super useful. Thank you for that, Joseph, excellent. Because I was wondering, I was thinking, strange, where are all the things? It's not stored by magic, so it needs to be stored somewhere. So containers, so it's really useful, thank you. So containers, and then once you got there, and you can see there, Affinity Designer. Now I'm gonna do photo, I'm not doing designer, but it's exactly the same Affinity Designer. Affinity Photo, and you see you've got there, data. So if you've got data there, that's where it is in the data file. So expand that out. Then you go down here to library. So expand the library out. This is like really weird, library within the library. Then weirdly, application scripts, application support. It's very strange, it's a combination of all these things. But you've got application support there, so it's got quite a, once you're down in there, then, let's just expand that out. Now, you can see all the various files. These are the key things. Got address book, not certain why that's in there. Autosave. Now, if you're suddenly finding you haven't got any space on your machine and you use Affinity Photo a lot and you've got some issues with like autosave and it's stored away, I actually found a load of gigabyte files in here. So you may find if you go to this folder and I just deleted them. Again, always when these things, you should always say, discretion, up to you, obviously make backups, be careful. If you don't want to do it, don't delete anything. I'm always happy to mess around with my ship machine. Not everyone is, I know, but you can, I just deleted it. It was a couple of gigs files. I thought, well, you know, I haven't got that much space on my machine, so I just deleted them. But again, it's your own risk. So with that, you got that. You've also got backup. Doesn't appear to be anything in it in my one. Crash reporter. Weirdly, got a file there from a couple of days ago. Maybe it's updated each time because I've had Photoshop. Affinity Photo. I shouldn't say Photoshop. Affinity Photo crashing a few times. Every application crashes. So you've got here default palette. Now that one hasn't been updated for a while. Don't know why. You've got iCloud in there. Lens profiles. I've got nothing in there. Personas, plugins, etc. Obviously, nothing in there because I've got no plugins, so I guess that's where the plugins. Presets, now the presets, where you would think all the presets would be stored, just has got this, swatches, that's it. So that, and profiles, you've got shortcuts. Now, the shortcuts, I guess, are where shortcuts are saved, so it says AF shortcuts there. But the key folder of all this is the user one. This is what I want to get down to, user. So you've got here, and again, if you want to reset Affinity Photo, I would suggest maybe, and I again, at your own risk, these files are the key files. And that's all I'm going to say because I'm not going to suggest anything to anyone. So adjustments. So you say you've done some adjustments and you can see adjustments here. I've got adjustments, this panel here. And I've added to that. Any presets you add to this, you can add presets. Well, it's stored here, you can see today. I just created this preset just to check it out, just to see that my preset is saved in this file. Obviously not very big, because it's only 6K, Okay, it's not kilobytes, not very much. Also assets. Now that's, you've got an assets panel. You've got an assets panel where you've got all your assets, all the various things. Anything that's stored in there, clearly is stored in here. Again, I updated it today. And you can see what happens. It's obviously updated it. And it's only 32 meg, which is not very big. So you've got that stored there. Develop, not certain what that is. Doc spread, not certain. Expressions, no idea. That was installed, saying that hasn't been changed on the day that I installed this, which is very weird. Expressions, I don't know what they are in Affinity Photo. No idea. So maybe something for the future to look out for. Who knows? Got here, fills, glyph. Now, some of them are .dat files, so they maybe have grids presets. Now, that's all the grid presets you save. You can save, obviously, this one. Well, obviously, clearly, I haven't saved anything because there's nothing in it. Macros. Now, I don't know if that's the macros because you don't save macros. Just it's a sort of like temporary sort of file. Maybe that's the library section because I haven't done saved anything to the library for a while. I would think that that's the library section. So even though it's called macros, it's probably the associated library. Because when you create a macro, you can save it to your library. Maybe that's that. Could go and test it quickly. I'm not going to do that now. Object styles, obviously there's styles, etc. Raster brushes. Now I just created a quick brush just to test my theory on this one. Raster underscore brushes, and it created an update. That's today. It's just, so any brush you make get stored in raster underscore brushes. Symbol dot pickup, no idea, it's a dot dat file. Tone maps, again, you can store tone maps. Tool settings, again, very odd because I didn't think I'd changed anything with the tools, but tools unset setting has obviously been updated recently. Vector underscore brushes, which is one of the oddest ones because there are no vector brushes in Affinity Photo. So why is that there? And likewise, has not been updated since the obviously the day I installed it. So maybe that's another feature that's possible. Who knows? I'm just speculating on vector underscore brushes. I would love to see vector brushes in Affinity Photo. Maybe it's just a placeholder that will be there. And I think that's always the great thing. When you look some of these things, you go through, and quite often I do, I love going through the these folders. Obviously got too much time on my hand, but if you go through the folders, you can often find things. You think, well, wonder why that is, XYZ. And you think, well, there is no feature called XYZ in the application. Is that something that's going to happen later? Who knows? It's just obviously vector underscore brushes, visibility underscore options dot that. So anyway, if you want to delete things and reset things, well, I'm just going to leave it to your own discretion about what you think about that, but it's an option. An autosave, check that out as well. Well, I hope you found this of interest. Like I say, it's slightly different from my usual videos where I'm talking about Affinity Photo. But actually, before I go, I will just quickly go up to show equivalent. So I'm just going to close that. And I go up to Affinity Designer. So here's Affinity Designer. And you can see the same structure. Library, application support, down there, application support. Expand into there. And you can see exactly the same. There, user, you've got adjustments, assets, develop, doc spread, expressions underscore presets again. Fills, glyphs, macros again, object styles, raster underscore brushes, tone maps. Now vector brushes, maybe that's the reason vector brushes in here. It's just paralleling, obviously, what's in Affinity Photo, Affinity Designer. Nice, maybe Publisher is the same as well. But Affinity Publisher is in what I consider the proper location. For some weird reason, this is stored in the container section. Do not know why. But that's for Designer, so you can see exactly the same things. And any change you make, and the files are fairly small here. I mean, they're not 327 bytes. Some of them haven't been updated since the day I put it on. So that's that. And again, you might find in like autosave, got nothing there, autosave. No Designer one autosave. So clearly that's a bit, let's say Photo, I've had a few times where it's crashed and obviously saved, autosaved lots of big files. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.